Hello Spinner, you're on Penstock, channel about pen spinning. My name is Alex Sukhov and today I will show you how to do a double charge reverse pen spinning trick. I don't think that you will see it a lot in different combos of upper intermediate pen spinners. Pen spinners don't usually use it fully, but if you are not such a great pen spinner, this trick alone will make you seem like a cool pro. It is also very helpful for improving your dexterity of your fingers. And even though you don't see it fully in different combos, you can see parts of double charge fall, for example. And all in all, double charge reverse, guys, it is something you really should know. So without any further ado, let's get started with learning it. It will be helpful if you already know how to do twisted sonic reverse. I really recommend you to learn this trick before trying to learn double charge reverse. And also will help you if you already know how to do warped sonic reverse. Because yeah, double charge reverse is basically a hybrid of twisted sonic reverse and warped sonic reverse. You can do this trick in slots 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, 3, 3, 4. And to my mind, the whole point of it is to learn how to do it continuously, because it looks much better than charge. Newbies really love to do just charge continuous, while there are a lot of different tricks which look much better than just that. And double charge reverse is definitely one of them. It doesn't only look cool, it also helps you to develop your dexterity of your fingers, as I told before. So the second part of this video, I will also show you how to do double charge reverse continuous. So first of all, let's take a pen mod in position 1, 2, because I'm going to show you this trick only in slot 1, 2, 2, 3. You can learn it in other slots using the same conception. We take a pen mod with middle finger at the center of it. So we take pen mod in such a position and begin to do twisted sonic. After you do twisted sonic, you need to let the pen spin, so this tip of it goes in circles. First it goes in circles here, and then it goes in circles there. So top tips of your pen mod are always doing circle motions. Well, this is a basic concept of twisted sonic actually, but here it will help a lot. Because as soon as it passes to 2-3 and goes around as well, here you need to bend the index finger, and when the pen makes circle and passes it, you just raise index finger and just stop pen at that point. But I will recommend you also to make this pass or warped sonic as circular as it is possible and make another charge in 1-2 after doing warped sonic. Learning pen spinning tricks is much easier and will give you much more fun if you're using a properly made pen mod with good balance and good weight. Each pen mod feels different and will give you different experiences. And the worst idea for you at this level, when you're already learning how to do double charge reverse, is using a simple pen. I actually have a separate video of why I think that you don't need to use simple pen in learning pen spinning tricks. At least most people don't need it. You need to have at least one pen mod to decide for yourself if you need them or not. And the best, easiest and cheapest way to get a pen mod is to go to penstock.net and to order it from there. It doesn't matter in which country you live in, you will get a pen mod from me. So to make this final charge also, when you pass the pen from 1-2 to 2-3, you need to pay attention in circular motions. Tips should always go in circles. So when pen is ready to be passed back to 1-2, you will curve middle finger and other fingers like ring and pinky. So at this approximate point, you will curve these fingers and then straighten them up doing charge. It will make doing charge, this last charge, easier for you. But I will recommend you to also try to at least to learn how to do this as less curving of your middle finger as it is possible. And still, you will need to make this last charge as circular as it is possible, because you will definitely need to give your pen mod enough momentum to move it forward to make another twisted sonic reverse. Both ways, with your middle finger curved and straightened, will look really awesome, but in case you are doing it this trick with a slightly bending of your middle finger, it will help you to reduce the risk of your pen hitting the bottom of your thumb when you do double charge reverse continuously. Because as you see, When you curve fingers, the pen risks to go here and hit palm or bottom of your thumb. But if you place them and hold middle fingers and all others straight, you don't have this risk, and doing double charge reverse continuously will be much easier for you. As soon as you bend them, pen will have this risk of hitting your palm. And when you hold and keep your middle fingers straightened enough and don't move it, don't curve it, you will definitely need to use your index finger much more. It will play a big role in doing this charge. And once again, you need to do the final charge of double charge. Pretty intense to give your pen mod enough initial inertia for doing another twisted sonic. And when you are able to do this, when you are able to do twisted sonic, then go to warped sonic and then another twisted sonic, you will be able to do this trick continuously, which will probably make you the coolest person in your area, not in the whole world though. So don't just spam with the double charges in different pen spinning related subreddits. For example, rpenspin, our official subreddit where all pen spinners are gathered and where you also want to join if you want to meet other buddies. I wish you good luck with all that in pen spinning. May the style be with you. Bye.